see that guy behind me? When I get in the car, I'll tell you a little story. It's not really a story, but just something I want to tell you.
Oh, mate. Anyway, that guy, he must be about in his 70s, probably 80s, I reckon. He's a bit of a cripple like that. One thing I admire about him massively is I see him walking miles every fucking day. I see him with a Costa cup in his hand. He walks, literally, we'll drive past him in a minute. I know exactly where he goes. I'm like fucking stalking him at this rate. I see him every day. He does the same thing every day, but he never gives up. Massive motivation. I want to be like that when I'm older.
So here he is. Go on, man. Just go.
This is what Diesel gets like when he goes for a walk. Starts crying like a little bitch.
Dude, look, this is Diesel having a piss. He don't cock up his leg. He hasn't learned to cock up his leg yet. Strange, very strange. This is the field that he, it's like a dog walking sort of area. As you can see, there's all the way down there, there's people down there. Bring Diesel here to kind of socialize with other dogs, because it's like a boxed off sort of area going around here where you can just let your dogs off of the lead and they can all socialize and stuff like that. And it's really helped with him. Like, he's not bothered about other dogs at all. He's got no aggression, no anger towards them. He's really, really good. The only thing he wants to do is just play with his sticks. Love to see it. He has a little run around with these little doggies. They cannot catch at all. He's so slow, bless him. Did you enjoy playing with your new friends? I think they burnt you out a little bit, Diesel, by the looks of it. You're knackered, mate, from that. He loves chasing. He always chases dogs. He likes chasing them.
Of course, I've got a stick. I'm going to throw it. See how well this goes.
Oh, you ready?
Go get it.
Loves it.
Good boy.
Let's go.
Yeah, my G. Look at him go. What a don.
As I've got older, one thing I've learned to appreciate is sitting by like the water and just listening to it. Just listening to it flow. Just sitting here relaxing. When I was younger, yeah, I used to fucking hate this. This used to be boring. Like, my parents used to invite me out on like days out and trips out to do this sort of stuff. And I think, this is really boring. But I thoroughly enjoy it now. As I've got older, I've learned to enjoy it a lot more. Now, the only thing I need is a little fucking zibby, you know, and just chill and sit here and relax a little bit. But we don't do that. That's illegal, and that's not what I recommend everyone doing. All right, Diesel. It's fucking soaking wet. Soaking wet. He literally fell in there earlier. Oh, Diesel, bruv. I'm soaking wet. He's taking the piss out of man, isn't he?
I'm gonna get ya. I'm gonna get ya. I'm gonna fucking get ya. I'm gonna get ya. I'm gonna get ya. I'm getting you. I'm gonna get ya. I'm gonna get you, Diesel. Run as far away as you can from me, I'm gonna get you. Come on.
So I've just came back home to clean my car. Use this Hoover. This Hoover's very, very good, by the way. If you've got a dog who's very hairy, this Hoover from Wix costs you about £40. Best Hoover ever. Because when you have a big, big dog, as you can see, the big, big dogs, they leave hair. Now, I don't just leave this blank like that. I've got a little cover for Diesel. This little cover thing here, which he sits on. I definitely recommend this if you've got a big dog as well. Putting this on your back seat, they clip over the headrest bit. Clip there, clip on the other side, and it works really nice. I'll show you once I've cleaned it what it looks like. If you've got a big dog, one of those will do. This Hoover will sort out your car. And now I'm bringing back memories of when I was in lockdown as well. My Myofit pull-down. Who remembers that? That was one of the best investments I made throughout lockdown. Cost me about £300. But the versatility of it in terms of what you could do on it, it was great. Because I could do my pull downs, I could do a seated row, I could do a bicep curl, I could do a tricep press down. I could do so much, I could do ab crunch, I could do loads of stuff on it. One of the best investments I made. Then I've got my weights. These weights, I've got about 210 kilos worth of weight. That cost me about £200. What am I chatting about? 400 quid, bro. Cost me 400 quid. Weights have gone all fucking rusty. Look at these bad boys. Not those ones. Look at them. Got all fucking rusty from just sitting here. So I might actually get rid of this shit, but I'm scared if we're going to go back into a lockdown. I don't really want to get rid of it. So we got that there. And then if you remember this bad boy. So I come over here. Who remembers this? Who knows what this is? That is my squat rack, believe it or not. Not in use anymore, as you can see. That is one of my most favourite videos I've done on this channel. It's got over 100,000 views on a shitty fucking squat rack that I built out of wood. It's crazy. And then in here, we've got the leg extension, the leg curl machine that I was using, as you can see. There's a seat, there's the back bit there, you've got the leg extension, you've got the leg curl bit. It was a piece of shit. It was one of the worst fucking leg extensions I used, but I paid £100 off Facebook Marketplace for it, and they cost about £300 on like Amazon and stuff like that, so I actually got it really well done there. But yeah, it was shit, it wasn't worth it. And then these are the ones which I built. These little weights which you can build out of, or make out of cement, I should say. I don't know what you want to call it, but yeah. Really good, brings back memories, man. Right, check how satisfying this is going to be. Look, you can just tell that's going to be so satisfying to fucking hoover.
You're beauty.
Right, what song are we going to kick off the drive to the gym to? You know them ones where you fucking put your phone on and think, right, it's got to be, the first tune's always got to be a good tune, isn't it? It's got to be a good tune to get your mind in the game. It's weird, like, I've been going through does anyone go through phases in the gym where they have to listen to music and then they go through phases they don't listen to music? Like, right now I'm going through a phase where I don't listen to music and I'm quite enjoying it. Strange little boy is what I say. I know Lucy's got a new song out. Make sure you follow my playlist, as I always say. Ever since I posted on YouTube the other week, I had like 2,000 followers, and now I've got 2,300 followers. So about 300 people have followed since. And I feel like the drill scene's getting a lot bigger as well, which is fucking sick. Love that. I'm the drill king on YouTube. You remember that, yeah? Fuck, I got you into drill, yeah? I'm not joking, I give a fuck. This isn't a Bunny's news. Bunny's got a new song. Two my step went over, each I round when you should have got woo. Each I round when you should have got woo. He got ying when he should have got woo. Thank the most high when you could have got woo. Me and bro, we made more, let's keep it real. I laugh for the sight when I see you spill. He got bum when he should have got woo. Each I round when he should have got woo. He got ying when he should have got woo. Thank the most high. Well, I won't leave till the whole clip empty. Them boy ain't none but pagans, I can see you. I'm in the band, don't know, okay, but I still punch. I'm more, one more stepper, arse and whistle, I'm going on shepherd. If I push that blade in your chest, I'll twist that bird to the whole thing redder. Right, enough of that. We love a little gym talk, don't we? Before we go into the gym, we sit here in our car and we think about what we're going to be doing. We're going to think about planning out how the session's going to go in our heads. I'm just going to, in my videos when I am training, I think I'm going to just do like a little car chat beforehand, just talk about what I'm thinking during my training sessions, that sort of shit. So, push today. I'm stalling on push for the last like 2-3 weeks now. Started stalling on like the incline dumbbell press. It's annoying because this gym, it goes from 50 kilo dumbbells to 54 kilo. And the 50 kilo dumbbells are completely different to the 54. The handles are literally like that thick, like thicker than my cock. And I'm thinking, I've got little girl hands. Like, you look at my hands, they're girly. And fucking, I can't hold on to them. So I can't imagine me pressing. And plus the dumbbells, which you can obviously put plates on, and you can like really bolt it together. You know, them sort of old school ones. So that is going to be an absolute nightmare trying to get them fuckers up. So I'm going to stick with the 50s for now. And I spoke to AJ earlier in the week and he said, fucking, you need to just build it up to like a set 11 or 12 before you go to the 54s, because, you know, from 50 to 54 is a big jump with dumbbells. I replaced a pet cuff fly, sorry, with a D-handle fly just because I preferred it. It felt much better. But other than that, mate, we're going to get our fucking beans in the game. So I'm going to sit here, I'm going to close my eyes, I'm going to tell myself, look, whatever's in this head right now that you're thinking about, fuck off for about 2 hours and come back to me then when I'm bothered about it. Because right now, this is my time. This is the Georgie boy time. This is 2 hours of my day to shine. 2 hours to make myself proud. 2 hours for me to just progress in my life. Obviously, I'm progressing outside of my life, but training-wise, progressing. And fucking sort it out. Sort it out. Sort it out. Work, school, if you're at school. Work, school, college, uni, work. Fuck off. Get in the bin and come back when I'm, you know. Right, let's do this. Got everything I need. My bag, my gym bag. My gym bag fucking stinks, mate. Fucking stinks. Let's get in this gym and let's take you for a push session.
It's WT. I see it. I want it. I click it. Come. Click it.
Got a little tip for cuff lateral raises. So if you obviously put the cuffs around like your forearm, wrist sort of area, the common thing I see a lot of people say is that it falls down. You know, the fucking cuff falls down and it makes it really uncomfortable and awkward. Get your wrist wraps. You see, these are the ones I'm wearing. There they are. Game changer. I promise you, if you put your wrist wraps on, these will not fall off. Final warm up, then we go to the working set.
clicking. Tanks weren't trying to whip it. Missing, missing. All my bands keep sticking. Swing me the log, I'm cashing it. T's got beef, you know that I'm backing it. Haters on me, they hate that I'm stacking it. Money on me, it's more than immaculate. Yeah. Clicking. Tanks weren't trying to whip it. Missing, missing. All my bands keep sticking. Swing me the log, I'm cashing it. T's got beef, you know that I'm backing it. Haters on me, they hate that I'm stacking it. Money on me, it's more than immaculate. Give me the Coinbase link with a T.
Finished off the final set, which was the third set with 20 reps. Fuck, it's hard. Trying to do 20 reps on a cuff lateral raise is not a joke. But honestly, between 8 and 20 reps is a really good place to work the side lateral raises. Just cover all of those, get good at it, get stronger. Obviously, control with accuracy. The internal stimulus as well. Feel it, get a good pump when you're done. You'll see your delts blow. So yeah, happy with those. Now we're gonna move on to a D-handle fly. Something I mentioned about in the car, which is new. So this is how I've set up my D-handle flies. Annoyingly, I have to put about fucking 100 kilos worth of weight on the back there, just so the bench doesn't move back when I'm doing the flies, because I'm, at the moment, I think I'm using more weight than my actual body weight, so the fucking bench moves sometimes, which is a real pain.
Yes, beat on my middle, I'll work that. If it weren't for the BTC, I would have no P. Thank God I don't work that. I'm always out trying to clean my P's out, need no drips, have the whip and reverse it. Stop the whip and reverse it. Any main, I'll work that. For the site was no VVV, but got OTP, that's an L, got a firm that. Now they introduced AVS, man, I'm getting stressed, how's man gonna work that? Fed up T's, now ass was chopping, he put me on, the grind ain't stopping. The middle's getting weird too.
Right now, you might be questioning why, George, why are you doing a cuff fly? I keep saying cuff fly, I'm not doing a cuff fly. I'm doing a D-handle fly, George. Get in your fucking head now, you stupid twat. Why are you doing a, oh, I'm gonna say cuff fly again, I swear to God, bro, I'm not even fucking joking. Why am I doing a D-handle cuff? Why am I doing a D-handle fly before I do any pressing? Surely you do your pressing first. And you're right, you would do your pressing first. Ideally, if you want to get stronger in your compound work, you need to be doing that first, called the priority principle. We know that compounds build big dense muscle. But the purpose of this is to really, one, obviously warm up your chest, ideally. I mean, if you can get strong like this and do a fly movement before you're pressing, could you imagine what it's going to be like when you get rid of the fly and then just do pressing straight away? I really do believe that I can engage my chest a lot more through doing this first. Yeah, I must admit it does take a little bit out of you in terms of the compound work. I'm thinking about the internal stimulus, so I've been guilty so much in the past of just pressing weight from A to B and not really finishing the set and thinking, oh, I felt that in my chest, feeling my delts, feeling my triceps, fucking hips are coming off, stuff like that.
Yeah, so I called up Mars and told him to dox him. Nah, I don't pay for shit. Nah, I don't pay for shit. I learned to click, yeah, tats got rich. Don't hit up the motive, still get lit. Look at my clothes, I click that shit. Look at these holes, I block that bitch. I'm all on my own, can't trust no bitch. I'm deep in this hole, I can't go lich. Click it, tanks weren't trying to whip it. Missing, missing. All my bands keep sticking.
Something which I've been doing lately with my pressing is actually using some liquid chalk. This is from Bolt Powders, as you can see. I think it's just a placebo effect, just like having a chalk on you just makes me grip the dumbbells a little bit better, especially when you've got like quite thick handles. I think using some liquid chalk, I just think it's mainly just in my head, like I just need to do it just to, you know when we all do that in life, you know, we just do something because it's just in your head and you just feel like, you feel more confident, you feel safer doing it. Same with this really.
Swing me the log, I'm cashing it. T's got beef, you know that I'm backing it. Haters on me, they hate that I'm stacking it. Money on me, it's more than immaculate. Clicking. Tanks weren't trying to whip it. Missing, missing. All my bands keep sticking. Swing me the log, I'm cashing it. T's got beef, you know that I'm backing it. Haters on me, they hate that I'm stacking it. Money on me, it's more than immaculate. Nowadays, everyone claims they're clicking, but ain't got a rack on their BTC. Load up on a new CC, this bin don't skip, that's a waste of pee. They ain't got bands, so they hate on me. I see these niggas, jealousy. In the 147, they envy me, but I gone clear now. Pray for me. This Jez keep talking about Gucci, no Gucci, just pass me the coochie. She wanna do dates and movies, day in the life, my life is a movie. I'm about my grand, can't use me, this one's dead, I'm trying a new piece. Don't tell my side thing about my newbie, I'm on my side, my clip me some Gucci. Who's he? I'm only getting gas now, who's he? Swing them deets, newbie. Click that shit, Susie. When I drip in Montclair, I click that shit. I was out in the field, I took that risk. Could have been in the team, I'm breaking bricks. I'm deep in this game, I can't go lynch. Click it, tanks weren't trying to whip it. Missing, missing. All my bands keep sticking. Swing me the log, I'm cashing it. T's got beef, you know that I'm backing it. Haters on me, they hate that I'm stacking it. Money on me, it's more than immaculate. Click. clicking. Tanks weren't trying to whip it.
Here's a little trick for you as well. So if the jump is too big, so this is a side lateral raise machine, it goes up in 5 kilo increments. 60 to 65 for me is too much of a big jump. So what I've done is I've got a 2.5 kilo, attached it into there with the 60, so 62.5. And we'll do a set like that and hopefully get a set of 8 to 10 instead of, if I did 65, I'd probably get fucking 6 or 5 reps, which is going to be shit. So if the jump is too big, add a little bit of a micro little fucking plate and you'll be good to go.
Missing. Missing, all my bands keep sticking. Shoot me the log, I'm cashing it. T's got beef, you know that I'm backing it. Haters on me, they hate that I'm stacking it. Money on me, it's more than a Mackie.
This is where we are, 97 weeks into my off season, so nearly 2 years since I last competed. I'm 183 pounds right now, which is nearly 40 pounds above stage weight. So that is push wrapped up. 97 weeks since my off season. It's as you can see from my body right now, you know, I'm quite soft, very soft actually, probably the softest I've ever been, but probably the strongest I've ever been. You know, I'm incline pressing the 50 kilo dumbbells. It's a part of the process. I know what my body needs. I know what I need to do, and I focus less on the look, more focus in the off season about what I'm doing, because shots like, you know, front double bicep, shots like front lat spread, as a natural in your off season, they never look great. Like, you've probably seen me just then, I don't look great. I really don't, but I know what's underneath this, and I know what is needed for me, and the best way I've got results is by pushing to my, surpassing my limits, pushing up my body weight, progressively eating, progressively overloading, doing stuff that I've never done before. Like, I've never incline pressed the 50s for a set 10 ever in my life. The stuff that I'm doing right now, it's gonna show when I dial back down, and I'm not too focused. Don't get me wrong, I'm looking at myself, but at the same time, I'm not taking it too much to heart, because I know what's underneath. And when we're pushing up, we never look as great. We never do, especially as naturals. That's the ugly side of it. And that's also why a lot of people limit themselves, you know, in terms of progress, is because they don't wanna push themselves. They don't want to get uncomfortable. They don't know how to get uncomfortable. And if you have that skill where you can really focus on locking into your training, really locking into not giving a fuck about how you're looking in your off season, then you can really level up your physique through just pushing to whatever level it might be. So like right now, I'm not happy with my look. I'm really not. Like, it's the worst I've ever looked ever. Believe me, I'm going to bring it when I'm next on stage. You're going to see a completely different package from the Georgie boy. So yeah, get home. I need a fucking spliff, bruv, and get me some fucking food, mate. I'm gonna wrap this video up here, guys. Content back. I've just got to a point now where I'm just posting. Like, stop overcomplicating it. Stop following trends. Just do me and do what works for me. And I'm really enjoying the editing. Really enjoying the recording side of things a lot more when I just do me. So, yeah. That's what's going to happen moving forward, and I'm going to keep on top of it for sure. If you enjoyed Teddy's video, pop it down below, mug. Lots of love. Hope you have a good day, good weekend, whatever. And as always, keep supporting the Georgie boy. Lots of love. And we'll see you guys soon.
Clicking. Tanks weren't trying to whip it. Missing. Missing. All my bands keep sticking. Swing me the log, I'm cashing it. T's got beef, you know that I'm backing it. Haters on me, they hate that I'm stacking it. Money on me, it's more than a man.